What's up, guys? Back with another Twinmotion tutorial. I'm going to show you quickly how to create an interior rendering using the Path Tracer. Let's get right into the video. All right, so the first thing that we're going to do is that we need to add some characters to our scene. So let's start adding some characters. And the way to do that is you go to your library and then you scroll down and then you have characters. And you can choose a selection of different type of characters, whether you want animated or groups or cutouts or posed humans or even animals. So we would go to posed humans, and you can also choose kind of for the event that you want to choose your character for, whether it's sports, business, construction, and you get the point. So we're not gonna go through all these, but I'm just going to choose the characters that I have saved in my user library. So I'm gonna back out. I'm gonna go to use the library, and here I selected Chaz, so we're gonna put him in position. Okay, so the next one we have Katie. Kind of make it look like she's looking inside the interior from the outside. And then we're gonna add also a couple here. Okay. All right, so the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna go back to our image. It's called Render One. We're gonna click on it. So now our characters are in position. If you're liking this video, guys, please do not forget to hit the like button. And we're gonna also get into the Path Tracer. So now that we got our scene set up, we're gonna start playing around with some of the settings here. And first thing I like to play around with on the settings is the environment tab. So time of day right now, we're at 14. We're gonna change that to 9:30. And also you have your sun intensity, which is at 100,000, and it usually comes standard that way. And for this one, we're gonna do 0. All right, so my sun reflection, moon intensity, and all that look fine. I'm not gonna mess with those. And it looks good. Okay, so right now my sun north offset is at 180 degrees. I'm going to switch that to 90. And when I'm always going into the details in the month, I'm always changing the month to where we are currently. So right now we are in June. Okay. So we're gonna enable our HDRI, and we're gonna leave, we're gonna keep it on the backdrop. Our intensity, we're gonna keep that one. And I'm not gonna change the approaching storm. I think that this particular HDRI fits perfectly for this scene. So I'm not gonna mess with the rest of those. We're gonna go to camera and kind of see what settings we can play around for our exposure. So let's turn our exposure down to 1. Our white balance is at 7800, and we want to actually bring it down to 4700. So it's starting to give it that cool feel, the cool look, instead of a real yellow look. So 4700. Okay. So now we got our vignetting, and the vignetting actually darkens the corners of our scene. And I think with the vignetting, 35% is actually where I want it. sharpness, let's go up to 40. And we're gonna keep the chromatic abbreviation on. So one thing that I always do is make sure that parallelism is checked, and we're good there. Guys, smash that like button for me. All right, so we're gonna go. So Twinmotion has added this new feature, film bank, which we are gonna enable today. And I think it's really cool. I think that adding this feature actually helps out a lot. So it kind of gives you presets of cameras. And right now I got it enabled, and the preset is at 16:9 film. I'm gonna change that to 35mm camera. So right now I'm just using my camera to help me frame the rendering as well. Oops. I also got bloom and flares, so it actually increases the intensity. So if you have any lighting, they give you several different options here, from simple to default and synthetic, and it goes on. We're gonna just leave it on simple. Okay, so before we hit rendering in the path tracer, let's go to FX and let's play around with some of our color grading. So our contrast is at 50%. We're gonna go with 55. Then we're gonna go to saturation, and we're gonna change that to 45. All right, so here in our color gradient, we can click on that, and we have several different options. And I wanted this scene to have a certain look, so I'm actually gonna choose a look called Nordic, if I can find it. All right, so Nordic is what I picked and chose for this color gradient. It is giving this cool look, but also this look that I saw in a black box theater. So if I didn't mention it before, this is a lobby space of a black box theater. And you can see the conference room in the center. And then you have your stairs that wraps around that conference room that leads up to the second floor. And then you have your paintings. So that's just a little bit of an overview, but we can keep going. So we can go to image. Okay, so go to image, and always want to make sure tile rendering is checked. I guess it just depends on what you're working on exactly. So the reason why this is grayed out is because in the camera settings we have the film back enabled. So now if you go back to image, now you can choose it. So I want 4K, and then if you go back to camera and do enable it, now we're set. So it saved the width and height now, but it would have locked it in 2K if we didn't do that step. All right, so let's go ahead and go get to the fun part. So now that we got all our settings in place, let's go to render, path tracer. So right now our quality is high, but I want to make it a good number of samples per pixel. I did 3000, I experimented with different samples per pixel, and 3000 just gave it that look, that crisp look that I was looking for this particular 3D scene. So I'm changing that, and also my max bounces are 25, and I left emissive materials and deboser checked, and fireflies I left it at 5. So right now path tracer is doing its thing, and as you can see, it just gave it that real nice look from your characters on the outside looking in. It looks like they're passing through, so it almost makes the image look like it's you have people on the outside of the exterior, on the exterior looking in, kind of walking through. So that touch kind of gave it that realism, that realistic look, in my opinion. So I mean, if you have any objectives to that, please share your comments down below. But yeah, so this is exactly how I created this 3D scene. Guys, please don't forget to hit the like button, and we will be back with another one